In 2010, Filipino-American filmmaker Drea Castro had a cinematic vision to uplift the disabled community, no matter the uphill battle. The hiker, who is training to be a sight guide for the visually impaired, began filming the documentary Baldy for the Blind. The film explores a group of blind hikers training and conquering the highest mountain and one of the most dangerous hikes in Los Angeles.
I'm a very avid hiker. I love hiking. It's something that I'm really passionate about, and I was supposed to be a sight guide. I was supposed to be, like, I was getting trained to be a sight guide, but then I realized that this story was very important, and so something was pulling at me to tell this story, and so here we are today, 13 years later.
With the subjects, community members, and disability rights advocates in attendance, the film premiered at the Dances with Film Festival in Hollywood earlier this month. The festival offers a platform for independent filmmakers and social issues to be heard. For Castro, this moment was a long journey. As a self-funded film, it took her 13 years to finally bring this to an audience.
Whenever you see a film that's made, it's a miracle, especially when it's an independent film, because you don't have the budget to have a full team. It was just me and my dear friend Matt that just worked on this for years and years, and he came later in the process. So I ran into a lot of struggle with it, and I just kept going, similar to the people in my film. Like, it's one foot in front of the other, and they really taught me about endurance and how you can get to the top of a mountain one step at a time. And so that this is my own mountain. I'm here today because of them.
The hikers featured in the film had different levels of sight. Some developed eye conditions later on in life, while others, like Pampanga-born Jojo Ronquillo, have been blind since birth.
Feels good to be on the poster, and I am glad to be in this movie at the same time. It was not easy. It was a lot of pain, but at the same time, it was worth it.
Disability advocates within the entertainment industry say while a quarter of people in America have a disability, less than 2% of people seen on film and television are disabled, with a majority of them played by non-disabled actors.
This film, like Baldy for the Blind, is very important because, you know, a lot of people are going to find this as an inspiration, but to me, this is just people out enjoying themselves and discovering the human experience.
And as Baldy for the Blind received a standing ovation, Castro hoped the audience takes away this message.
Everybody has their own mountain, but you can climb it. And it doesn't matter how hard it is, it doesn't matter how long it takes, it's one step at a time and you can get there. And the fact that people in the disabled community, the overlooked community, the blind community, the low vision community, they're overlooked, but they are very, very able. They are very able and they can do anything that they want to. And I hope that when you see my film, when people watch it, that they, you know, that the stereotype that they had in the past will be broken.
Castro now has plans to bring the film to London later this fall and has several other festivals and screenings lined up. Steve Angels, ABS-CBN News, Hollywood.